Welcome students. In today's lecture, we will learn about design of bolted joints. Bolted joints is one of the technique that is used to connect material together to form the mechanical structures. These joints are used to hold two or more machine parts together. This part can be dismantled if required without any damage to the machine parts or fastening. This type of joints are also known as detachable joints. So before designing any of the bolt, we need to check its application and the condition of loading. The various cases which we are going to study in this topic will be: the first one, eccentrically loaded bolted joints, where the load is in the plane of the bolts. Second, eccentric loading perpendicular to the axis of bolt. And third, eccentric loading if load is parallel to the axis of the bolt. Starting with the first case, where the eccentrically loaded joints with loading on the plane of the bolts. In the figure you can see there are around 10 bolts and the load W is acting in the plane of the loads. The plane where the load acts and the plane where the bolts are arranged are in the same plane. Now let us see how to solve this kind of problems. Okay, so let us begin with type 1 problem, wherein the load which is applied is in the plane of the bolting system. Okay, so let us start with the first problem, which says an eccentrically loaded bolted joint is as shown in the figure. All the bolts are of same size. Determine the size of the bolts if shear stress permissible is 50 MPa. The diagram is given like this. The number of bolts on this bracket are 7, 3 on the first line, then 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th. The distances of the bolts are given as the vertical distance between each bolt is 100. Similarly, the horizontal distance between each bolt is 100 and the load is located at a distance of 500 mm from the center line of the bolt and the applied load is 8 kN. The first step in any of the problem of this kind is to find out the CG of the bolted system. I repeat, we have to find out CG of the bolted system only, not of the entire system. Okay, so I have made a bolted system separately here, showing only the bolts, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 located at distances which were given in the diagram. Now to calculate the CG, from basic principle we know that if the figure is symmetric about y-axis, in this case if I can say that my bolt system is symmetric about y-axis, hence CG will lie on this line only. So with this basic concept I can directly write x is equal to 100 mm if I take my reference bolt as 6. So from this point to this point distance will be 100. Now my aim is to find out y bar. What will be the y bar from this particular reference? So we have the relation y bar is equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 so on till a7 y7 since the number of bolts are 7 divided by the area of each bolts up to 7. Now in this formula we need area and distances of each bolt in y direction from our reference point. So you can look here, the distance of bolt 1 in y direction from our reference point is 100 plus 100, that is 200. Similarly, for bolt 2, 200, bolt 3, 200, bolt 4 and 5, 100 and 6 and 7, 0, because they are on the same line. There is no distance in y direction from bolt number 6 divided by area of each bolt. Now, in the question it was given that the area of each bolt are same, or the bolts are of same size. So taking area common from numerator and denominator, we get this value. Y bar is equal to, it will remain the distance only, 200 plus 200 plus 200 plus 100 plus 100 plus 0 plus 0 divided by 7. On solving, you get y bar is equal to 114.28 mm, wherein I can say the centroid of this particular bolted system lie at a distance of 114.28 mm from my reference point, that is 6. So if I locate the CG on this particular bolt system, I will mark X 100 and Y 114.28. So this distance from point number 6 will be 114.28 mm. After finding step 1, that is finding out the CG of the bolt system, next step is to find what is the effect of this load on this particular bolt system. Okay. What is the effect of the load on this bolt system? Now we know that load, wherever it is applied on the body, it has been assumed that it will be acting at center of gravity. So now let us shift this load to center of gravity, which we have already defined, and see what will be the effect of this load on this bolt system. This is the entire bolt system in which the load is acting at a distance of 500 mm from the center line. So as discussed earlier, we need to shift this load from this particular point to CG. Again, from the basic concepts, we know that if we shift a load from one point to another point, there also exists a couple. So now let us shift this point. So if I shift this load from here to CG, so it will be like this. The load will be coming here of 8 kN. And as it is shifted, it will also introduce a couple between with a value of 8 multiplied by 500, the distance by which it has been shifted. Now, this couple came into existence because this load was shifted from this point to this point. Actually, the load was only vertical. Hence, this vertical load will be known as the primary load, and this couple, which is introduced because of shifting this load from this point to this point, will be known as secondary force or secondary effect. So there are two effects, primary effect and secondary effect. Primary effect due to the vertical force, and secondary effect due to couple. Case 1. Considering primary effect of the force. So as discussed, the primary effect will be due to this vertical loading. Now from this diagram, you can see that when this load is applied in vertical direction, all these bolts will be displaced by some distance. Or I can say that all the bolts will be sheared off in downward direction. So we can say that the primary effect of the force on all the bolts is the shearing effect of the bolts. So we can write the shearing effect or the primary effect will be P1 dash. So this one indicates the bolt number and this single dash indicates that it is a primary effect. So we have P1 dash is equal to P2 dash is equal to P3 dash and so on is equal to P7 dash. All the bolts will be sheared off with equal force. Okay, so this entire load of 8 kilonewton will be distributed among 7 bolts. Hence I can write this is equal to 8 into 10 raised to 3 converting into newtons divided by 7. So finally I will get this will be equal to 1142.85 newtons. So this will be the primary effect on each bolt. Okay. So primary effect on each bolt will be 1142.85 newton, and this is because of this vertical loading of this couple on the bolt system, that is the secondary effect of the force. If this is a couple in clockwise direction, this all bolts will try to tilt, and this tilting will be perpendicular to the radius. For example, this bolt will be tilted in this direction, that is perpendicular to the radius. Similarly, bolt 2 will be tilted in this direction, bolt 3 will be tilted in this direction, and so on and so forth. So at last we will see that this bolt 6 will be tilted in this direction, which will be perpendicular to the radius. Let us name them P1 double dash. This double dash states that it is a secondary effect, and as usual this one will be the number of bolt. Similarly, this will be P3 double dash, this will be P6 double dash, and so on. In previous case or the primary effect, we have seen that all the bolts will be sheared, or the shearing force will be equal in all the bolts. But in this case, it will be different for each bolt because the distances from CG of each bolt is different. So we have, let us say, in general terms, we have P is directly proportional to R. That is, load acting on the bolt will be directly proportional to the radius. The greater the radius, the greater will be the shearing force. So if we remove the proportionality sign, we will get P is equal to C into R, where C is the constant of proportionality. So I will get, if I calculate for load or bolt 1, I will get P1 double dash is equal to C multiplied by R1. Similarly, P2 double dash C multiplied by R2, where R2 is the radius of bolt 2 from CG. Okay. Similarly, I will write P3 double dash is equal to C into R3, where R3 is the radius from CG to bolt number 3, and so on. I can write last 7 double dash is equal to C into R7. The next step is to find out value of C, that is constant of proportionality. So we have the by formula C is equal to P multiplied by E divided by the distance is square, which is actually applied, that is we are given as 8 kilonewton. E is eccentricity. Eccentricity is the distance by which the load has been shifted from its original position. So we have shifted our load by 500 mm, so for our case E will be 500. Next is distances of R1, R2, R3, etc., where R1 is the distance from CG to bolt number 1. So if I draw this, so this will become as your R1. Similarly, R2 will be distance from CG to bolt number 2. Okay. Now our aim is to find out R1, R2 and so on by the distances which is already given. We have already found out the distance of this point G is 114.28 mm from bolt number 6. Now, if I want to find out R1, I will just construct a triangle considering 1 and G. I need R1, so I would require these two sides. This side is already given to me as 100. And this side will be, this total is 200. And this, from this point to this point, it is 114.28. So I will get it as 85.71. That is 200 minus 114.28. Okay. So finally, I will get, therefore, R1 is equal to square root of 100 square plus 85.71 square. Therefore, I will get R1 is equal to 181.71 mm. Similarly, I will find out R2. R2 is the distance from CG to bolt number 2. So in this case, it is just perfect vertical distance. So directly I can write R2 is equal to 85.713 mm. Similarly, I will write for R3. R3 is distance from CG to bolt number 3. So if you will closely observe, as this point A and 1 and 3 are symmetric to each other, distance will also be same. So I can write R3 also equal to as 181.71 mm. Then let us find out R5. Okay. For R5, we need to construct this triangle. Again, this distance is known to us as 100 mm. This distance is, this will be 114, and this distance from year to year, it is 100. So I will remain with 14.28. So I will get, therefore, R5 is equal to square root of 100 square plus 14.28 square. So I will get is equal to 101.01 mm. Now as point number 4 is symmetric, I will have the same value for 4 also. Next step, find the value of R6. Again same procedure, joining this point 6 with G. So I will get R6 is equal to, so this is 100 and this is 114.28. So R6 will be 100 square plus 114.28 square. So I will get, therefore R6 is equal to 151.86 mm. And as bolt number 7 is symmetric, I can also write R6 comma 7 is 151.86 mm. There is some calculation mistake here. This is not 181, this comes out to be 131.71. Similarly, this will be also 131.71. Now next step will be to find out the value of C. Substituting value of P as 8 into 10 raised to 3, E as 500, and all the values of R1 and R7 has been found out in the earlier stage. So with this we get the value of C as 36.84 Newton per mm. Now next step will be to find out all the secondary effect of forces, that is P1 double dash till P7 double dash. So we have the relation P1 double dash is equal to C multiplied by R1. So substituting the values, we will get the value of C is 36.84. So it will be 36.84 multiplied by R1 we got as 131.71. So finally we will get answer as 4852.37 newtons. And as we saw, as it is symmetric, the value of P1 and P3 both will be same. Next, P2 double dash will be C multiplied by R2. So it is 36.84 multiplied by R2 was 85.713. So this will give you answer as 3157.66 newton. Similarly, we will find out for P4 and similarly P5. Both will have same values, C multiplied by R4, or you can write on R5. So 36.84 multiplied by 101.01, which will give you answer as 3721.20 newton. And lastly, P6 or 7 double dash will be C multiplied by R6 or R7. That will be 36.84 multiplied by 151.86, which will give you answer as 5594.52 newton. So till now we have found out all the primary effect of forces and all the secondary effect of forces. Next step, we need what is the resultant force acting on each bolt, that is the combined effect of primary and secondary forces. As we have seen earlier, let us say on bolt 1, this is the primary effect of the force and this is the secondary effect of the force. Similarly, on bolt 3, this is primary effect, this is secondary effect. On bolt 7, this is primary effect and this is secondary effect, and so on and so forth for all the remaining bolts. Now we are interested in finding out what is the resultant of these forces. We don't need primary force, we don't need secondary force. We need what is the resultant force acting on this bolt. So we have the formula by parallelogram law of forces that P is equal to root of, let us say I am considering for seventh bolt, so I will write P7 is equal to, or resultant force on bolt 7 is equal to P7 dash square plus P7 double dash square plus 2P7 dash P7 double dash cos of theta, let us say 7, where theta is the angle between the two forces. Now, why I have found out only for P7, why not all the bolts? Now again, from basic we know that the farther the bolt is from the CG, the greater will be the amount of force. So the farthest point from CG is either 6 or 7. So you can calculate any one, either 6 or 7, to minimize your time. So I've been calculating P7. So the requirements are P7 dash, that is the primary force acting on bolt 7, which we have already found out. P7 double dash, that is also found out. Now the next aim is to find out what is theta 7, that is the angle between these two forces. So for this we will have some construction. Joining this G to 7, which we named it as R7 earlier. We also know that this force always act perpendicular to the radius. So this is 90 degree. Just joining this point number 7 with G. Now I know this value, this is 114.28. This also I know 100. So in this triangle G7 and let us say O, G7 and O, I can find out this angle, let us say theta. So I will get tan theta is equal to, opposite is 114.28 divided by, adjacent is 100. So I will get theta value as 48.81. Okay. So if this angle is 48.81, this will become 90 minus theta. Now again, this is 90, and if this is 90 minus theta, this will also become theta. That means this angle will be equal to this angle, or I can say theta 7 will be equal to theta, which is 48.81. So now also I know all the values, so I will substitute. So I will get P7 is equal to square root of P7 dash square, that was 1142.85 square, found out in the earlier stage, plus P7 double dash, that is secondary force, we found out as 5594.52 square, plus twice 1142.85 multiplied by 5594.52 multiplied by cos of this angle 48.81. So on calculating, I will get P7 is equal to 6405.15 Newton. So this is P7, or I can say it is P max, the maximum force on the entire bolt system, which will be on P7. So I can write, instead of P7, I can write P max is equal to 6405.1 newton. The forces, or the resultant forces, or other bolts will be definitely less than this one. Okay, so after finding out forces or maximum force, now I will go for the finding out size of the bolt. So we know that shear stress is equal to force upon area. Shear stress is already given in question, allowable 50. Load we already found out, 6405.15 newton, divided by area of the bolt can be written as pi by 4 d square. So on calculating, I will get d is equal to 14.27 mm. Now this d which we get will be core diameter of the bolt, that is DC. So I got DC as 14.27 mm. Now going to PSG 5.42, standard of bolts available. So from that I will get for DC as 14.27, I have the value of D is equal to 16.99 mm, or I can write the size of the bolt is M18. This completes the solution. Thank you. Let us see the second problem of the same kind. It says a steel plate subjected to a force of 8 kN is fixed to a channel by means of 3 identical bolts. The bolts are made up of 45C8 material having yield strength as 380 Newton per mm square. If factor of safety is 2.5, determine the size of the bolt. The diagram and the related dimensions are given. Step 1, find out the CG of the bolt system. So I have made here bolt number 1, bolt number 2, bolt number 3, and selecting my bolt number 3 as your reference point. So by observation we can say that bolt number 2 will be the CG of this bolt system, which I can say it lies at a distance of 75 mm from bolt number 3. So we can directly write G is, X will be 0, Y will be 75 mm. Now considering case 1, that is primary effect of load. So again there are 3 bolts, so I need to shift this load of 8 kN to the CG point. So when I shift this load will come here along with a couple of 8 multiplied by 300. This is 8 kN. Bolt number 1, bolt number 2, 3. So primary effect is the vertical force. So we can write P1 dash, that is primary effect on bolt 1, will be equal to primary effect on bolt 2, will be equal to primary effect on bolt 3, and this will be equal to 8 multiplied by 10 raised to 3 divided by 3, which comes out to be 2666.67 newton. Case 2, secondary effect of load. So here we will encounter only the secondary effect, that is the effect due to this couple. Now, because of this couple, this is the radius from CG, bolt 1, bolt 2, bolt 3 from CG. So we have seen in earlier case that it will be perpendicular to the radius. Similarly, this is the radius to bolt 3, so this will be perpendicular to the radius, and this I will term it as P1 double dash, this I will term it as P3 double dash. So again, by basics, we have P is directly proportional to R, so I can write down P is equal to CR, or P1 double dash is equal to C into R1, P2 double dash C into R2, P3 double dash C into R3. Next step is to calculate the value of C. So we have formula, C is equal to P multiplied by E divided by R1 square plus R2 square plus R3 square. So in this, P is 8 kilonewton, so 8 into 10 is to 3 multiplied by E, how much amount we shifted. So distance from CG to the load is 300 as given in the diagram, divided by R1. R1 is radius of bolt 1 from CG. So this is also given in question as 75, and this is also 75. So I will write R1 square, that is 75 square, plus R2. R2 is the distance of bolt 2 from CG. But as both are same points, there is no distance here. So 0 square plus R3 is distance of bolt 3 from CG. So it is again 75 square. So with this I will get, by solving, C as 213.33 newton per mm. So as I got C, I can find out the values. P1 double dash is equal to C into R1. So 213.33 into 75, which I will get as 16,000 newton. Similarly, P2 will be 0, and P3 double dash will be equal to P1 double dash, as C and R1 and R3 are same. So again, 16,000 newton. After finding out the primary and secondary effect of the forces on each bolt, now it's time to find out resultant of forces on each bolt. So again, I will make the diagram. Bolt number 1, bolt number 2, bolt number 3. So we have primary force acting on bolt 1, P1 dash, secondary force P1 double dash, similarly P3 dash, P3 double dash, and here it is P2 dash, and this is also the CG of the bolt system. Now we have, by parallelogram law of forces, P1 is equal to square root of P1 dash square plus P1 double dash square plus 2P1 dash P1 double dash cos of theta 1. Now in this, theta 1 is the angle between primary and secondary forces. So from here, this diagram, we can directly see that the angle between primary and secondary force is 90. So I can write here P1 is equal to, substituting the values, root of P1, that is primary force, was 2666.67 square plus P1 double dash, that is secondary force acting on bolt 1, which was 16,000 square. And then, as we know that theta is 90 degrees and cos 90 is 0, so this terms vanish out. So we will remain with, or we will get P1 is equal to 16220.7 newtons. Similarly, as the distance of bolt 3 is same, also the angle is same, we will get P1 is equal to P3. So finally, I can write the maximum force acting on bolts is P is equal to 16220.7 newton. Now, in question we are given material, that is sigma y is equal to 380 newton per mm square, and also FOS is given, so I will find out sigma allowable as 380 divided by 2.5, so I will get 152 newton per mm square. This is sigma tensile allowable, so I will get shear stress allowable is equal to 0.5 into 152, which is 76 newton per mm square. So now, using the shear stress formula, stress is equal to P by A. So stress is known, 76, P is known to us, 16220.7 divided by, area can be written pi by 4 d c square. So from here, if I calculate, I will get d c is equal to 16.484 mm. Now seeing this in PSG, 5.42, the nearest value will be d is equal to 19.624 mm, or I can write m 20 volt. Thank you.